That's a great question. What is Ops 4.0? And I get that question a lot. So there are two elements of it. 4.0 is basically we are in the next technology jump. First jump was steam engines. Second jump was when the assembly production started. Third jump when the robots for the first time started up showing up in the manufacturing world. And now we are in the fourth jump. And this is largely around digital analytics, computing power being brought to bear to increase the productivity in operations. So that's literally Ops 4.0 in terms of in a next technology jump, enabling next 20% of productivity by focusing across functions in operations. So the implications for the companies is number one, is that they just need to look at a value-based view that what will create value for them and when. Second implication for the companies is out of the initial assessment, if they do, of where the value will come for them, the answer it might be that for the next 1 or 2 years, I want to focus on only one thing. Then that's perfectly fine because focusing on one and doing good job at it is better than doing a lot of pilots. The third implications for the companies is also focus on the capabilities of the people. Sometimes maybe invest in the capabilities of the people before the investment in the technology. And the last implication for the companies is, since a lot of this thing is evolving, the answer for each of the company will also evolve. On the key elements of successful transformations, to me, number one is bold aspiration. If you're transforming, then you're transforming to breakthrough. Second particular thing, key thing in the transformation is ensuring sustainability is equally part of as in day one. And identifying the talent upfront in the transformation, whom you really want to build the capability of, and focus and invest in their capability through the transformation is going to be very, very important. Because then people can see that, okay, this person was a high performer, got an opportunity on transformation, and then got to a great place. One of the most successful transformations which I've been involved in and I'm proud of is when we did this transformation in 2007, 2008, they really picked their high potential people to lead different teams. And all of those people within, call it 8 years, ended up being the top leaders of that company. From the CEO to the presidents to the VPs. So that is the vision which a CEO should have from a capability building and using transformation as a vehicle to also develop the next generation of leaders for the companies. The last part which I would say is rigor in track and trace. That is very, very critical. And I think we do it through our tools called Wave anyway, but just having that rigor and transparency on where each idea is, and there might be 20,000 ideas, and then what is happening to each of the idea, every milestone, that transparency and rigor is very important. So to summarize, big, bold ambition upfront, a target which people feel uncomfortable with. Number two, ensuring that the capability building and the talent development is baked in from day one. And number three is rigor in performance management by creating full transparency across all of the ideas for everyone. Those things to me brings transformation to be successful in any organization.